Good morning, students. Today we are going to continue with our chapter insulation. In our previous class, we have studied about the four processes: radiation, conduction, convection, and advection, those directly responsible for heating the atmosphere. Today we are going to study about the difference between the weather and the climate. Weather is the atmospheric condition of a particular place for a short period of time with respect to its one or more elements, such as temperature, pressure, wind, humidity, precipitation, sunshine, and cloud cover. Weather conditions can change rapidly, whereas climate is the average atmosphere prevailing in an area over a considerable period of time. Climatic averages are calculated over a minimum of 35 years. Temperature plays a very important role as it controls the amount of water vapor present in the air. The processes of evaporation and condensation are finally the relative humidity is the proportion to the temperature. Cloud formation and humidity are also influenced by it. Now we will discuss about the factors that influence the weather and climate. First, we will study about the latitude. As you can see in this image, due to the spherical shape of the Earth, the angle of incidence of the sun's rays is not similar everywhere on the surface of the Earth. When the sun's rays are vertical 90 degrees over the equator, they are at an angle of 40 degrees at 50 degrees north and south latitude, and 0 degree at the two poles. The revolution of the Earth around the Sun on an inclined axis causes seasonal variation in the angle of incidence of the Sun's rays. This is also caused seasonal variation in the duration of sunlight. Next, we will study about the altitude. Relief features influence the temperature in many ways. In our previous class, we have discussed about the normal lapse rate. It means that the temperature decreases normally at the range of 1 degree Celsius per 167 meter of height. This explains the marked difference in temperature between Delhi and Shimla. While Delhi has a mean temperature of 33.3 degree Celsius in June, Shimla records only 19.4 degrees Celsius. There are two reasons for the decrease of temperature with altitude. One is that of the atmosphere gets heated below upwards by terrestrial radiation. The lower layers of the atmosphere are denser and they contain water vapor, dust, and other particles which absorb heat. At higher levels, the air is rarefied, and the absence of water vapor and dust particles permits the escape of radiation back to space. Therefore, the air is cooler in the mountainous region. As we can see that the relief features also modify the temperature by forming a barrier to the movement of winds at lower levels. For example, the lofty mountains that prevent the movement of cold winds from Central Asia towards the northern plain of India, which experience a comparatively mild winter. Next, we will study about the distance from the sea. Land heats and cools more quickly than water. This is because of the higher specific heat of water. This results in a greater range of temperature between days and nights in summer and winter in continental interiors compared to the coastal regions, where the cooling effect of the sea moderates the temperature day and night and throughout the year. Next, we will study about the influence of the ocean currents. When onshore winds blow over a warm current, they pick up moisture and bring more rain to the coastal region. For example, westerlies brings plenty of rain to Western Europe throughout the year, whereas the winds that blow over the cold current pick up very little water vapor and gives little or no rainfall at all. Example, the cold Benguela current along the coast of Southwest Africa. The cold current along the coast of California makes the coastal region cooler than normal. The most striking example of a warm current is the warm Gulf Stream, and its continuation called the North Atlantic Drift. These warm currents are responsible for raising the winter temperature in the coastal regions of Northwest Europe. Next, we will study about the different winds. Winds blowing from the ocean during summer tends to reduce the temperature of the place along the coast because oceans are cooler than land masses. They also bring rain as they are onshore winds. Winds blowing from the lower latitudes are warmer than those blowing from higher latitudes. Local winds associated with the passage of cyclones cause sudden changes in the temperature. The Föhn is a hot dry wind which blows down the slope of the Alps towards the valleys. They often blows with great violence. In spring, they cause snow to melt very quickly, making the pastures available to the sheep and cattle. The Chinooks coming down the Rockies in North America have a similar effect on the snow. The Lou is the example of hot dry wind which blows over the part of western Uttar Pradesh during summer. Mistral and Bora are the example of cold winds which reduce the temperature of the places along the Mediterranean coast of Europe. In the tropical regions, the sea breeze blows along the coast in the afternoon and it reduces the temperature and makes the evening pleasant. So in this way, we have seen that the different things affect on the climate. These different factors influence the weather and climate of any area. Now the next we will discuss about the clouds and rainfall. During the day, clouds prevent insulation from reaching the earth's surface. Clouds also prevent the escape of terrestrial radiation during the night. Clear skies permit insulation readily during the daytime and allows the rapid escape of terrestrial radiation during the night. Now at the very end, we will study about the natural vegetation. Natural vegetation checks radiation from the upper layers of soil, causes the lesser range of temperature variation between forested areas and desert. The thick foliage of the Amazon jungle cuts off much of the incoming solar insolation, causing the shade temperatures to be lower than those of the open spaces. So in this way, we have studied that how latitude of a place, altitude, distance from the sea, ocean currents, winds, and the natural vegetation affects or influence the climate and weather of an area. Thank you, students.